Yeah, in 2009 is now when I began, like, seriously. I realized that this is a serious thing and it has potential to earn me money. Like, my first payment from ZK was in the hundreds of thousands. You know, that's a new agency, man. I realized this thing has potential. So I just kept on figuring out, what does my client want?
Yep.
What are their needs? So they send me briefs. I respond to the briefs. I create a proposal. Kitambo, my proposals were full of words. Nowadays, it's mostly imagery. So now, before I had to read proposals and I'm presenting like a student, nowadays I talk through meetings. Nowadays, even some clients, I woke up with a tab and they're like, talk to me.
Mm.
They want to hear DNG. Like yesterday, I was in a meeting in a Kikao and my clients were like, this, because we're talking about my NGO and the initiatives I have for young people. And they're like, just tell us what it is that you want to do and how you'd want us to assist you to do what you want to do.
Mm.
So it's me talking.
Yep.
It's reached that level of business now, which is beautiful.
Yeah, it is. It's a sweet spot. Of course,
I still do the due work of coming up with a presentation, in case you want to see how it's there, what's the look and feel like, what's the mechanic, how are we going to activate, what's the execution plan from this, how do we move to this, that, the other, how do we structure, what's the roadmap. I do all that because that's what I do as an agent. That's what we do as an agency. But I've reached a level of even perhaps self-confidence and trust for my clients, that they trust that what I say I'm going to do, I will do. And those are the clients who give me Biasha.
Mm.
Brand trust, either from referral or from my engagement or just meeting me. There are clients who just love your personality and love your truth.
Mm.
Not all clients will say yes. Some will say no. In fact, I keep encouraging my team because there's a client who told me, a client who I used to serve as a subcontractee or subcontractor, they used to tell me, out of 100 proposals, or out of 10, you get one.
Mm.
Perhaps even nowadays with the economic decline, it's the odds are, and probability is less. Odds are against us more. And obviously competition, undercutting, changing, etc. And nowadays, people are doing this thing. It's not like how it was in the beginning.
Yep.
Nowadays, many people are doing events. Many people are doing marketing of some sort.
Teams even have their own in-house teams to do their own.
Yeah, in fact, I was laughing with a client and I was like, all this biashara you used to give us, nowadays you have a team to do it. Digital, influencing. Mm. Now there's a team of young guys even doing content creation within an organization.
Yep.
They've bought cameras.
Mm.
They are shooting things and putting them on online.
Yep.
So do you really need an agency? Perhaps it's a dying model.
It actually is very funny. That's what made me transition my company, because I looked at the future. I just said, nah, me, you pay me now to talk. So what I did is I transitioned my whole team to my clients, because of course I got to be client servicing. So I just be like, okay, in this next year, we're going to transition.
Yeah.
Because I could see where it was going. Too many guys were entering the game, but even the ones entering the game, the clients, because we had been disruptors, came in, even our pricing model disrupted everything and our speed of delivery.
Yes.
But I could see that the clients were moving to a place where they want their own internal team. Yeah. The same way you've got your team here.
Correct. And it's also more affordable.
It is.
Because for clients to have their own teams. Yes, and we appreciate that. In fact,
I say you have to operate like a media house. Every business
needs to think
like a media house in terms of how much content they create. Mm. So that content can't be outsourced, because you're not shooting one video a day.
Yeah.
You're shooting three videos
a
day.
The MD is going here, the CEO is going here, there's a thing here for marketing, the conference here. We have so it's working like that.
So I'm shocked to hear that this thing also, not shocked. I'm hearing about the evolution also happening within your eventing space.
Yeah. And you find that it's so strange that even some of our most or highest paying clients nowadays, you find that even things like having brand ambassadors, I mean like the activators who push product that we manage as an agency, they're doing it internally.
Yep.
So aka what do you call them? Like the trade marketers or marketing managers are now being tasked to handle that work of looking for BAs, shortlisting them, training them, deploying them.
That's crazy. Reporting. Yep.
So some try it, fail, and come back. And we have no issue. We appreciate our clients, even those who are most honest with us. And I like that because business is an evolution. It's a, yep. It's a dynamic.
And if you catch, you die. Yeah,
some tell us, Haki DNG, we've tried to do it on our own, where our sales team has been pushing us to cut back on costs, but we can't. It's not our core business.
Yep.
So we come back and we're like, okay, we're ready to still serve.
Okay, let's switch on a bit. We'll come back, or you'll incorporate the company as we're having this conversation. Let's talk about your entry into radio.
Yeah, so radio is very interesting because I was hosting an event called Pepea na Harambe Stars. It was an event organized by Kenya Data Networks. Very interesting company. And this event was to fundraise for Harambe Stars to go ngambo for a game. So now Harambe has always had issues of choice.
Yeah.
KFF, big up. Maybe one day we'll overcome. And take sports and talent seriously as a nation. Because it's saddening that our national team
is fundraising.
And we have a minister, we have a president, we have a federation.
There's a budget even for it. Me, I'm like,
but the budget never reaches down to the players. They can't get even a flight or a hotel.
Yeah, I'm like, a president should never remove money from his pocket to pay for guys to go.
Yeah, or a governor.
That's rubbish.
That means it's a systemic breakdown.
Exactly. That should be incorporated into the budget, into the system of the...
Yeah. And anyway, government is a whole new conversation.
Yeah, anyway, to endele. So, so you invite me again. You'll MC in this gig.
So I'm MCing this gig. So we're fundraising. So some of the guys in attendance are big names in media and all that. So I see Caroline Mtoko and I'm like, yo, Caroline, askiangweni mdosi sana. Kujapa nang katenta auto edo hapa saa hii. Kwa niko nini? Wase! Hey! Caroline Mtoko atoe do, asitoe do.
No way.
Atoe do. Nyayo stadium buda. Ni noma, ni mbaya. Akashuka. Kwa pitch. I'm in the middle of the pitch, the stadium. Sawa. Siku do two gigs a club. Niko kwa stadium sasa.
Yeah.
Naongea na umati. Na unajua maumati wa ball. Wenye raia wa ball wanakuanga. Dyad, Gor, Nini, FC, Harambe, like soccer is a thing here. It's like politics.
Yeah.
So na chocha Caroline akashuka. Nakatwado. And during that event, I think we're having lunch thereafter. Still within the whole complex. So na sasa na get kumongelesha nini. So Jalangu is at that time working at Kiswanande. So naambia Jalangu ni aje manze. So nishikanisha na Caroline Mtoko manze nipate job hapa kwa radio manze.
Yo, bro, so you wanted radio? You
wanted to get it radio? I've always looked for the next
evolution.
Yes. And
of the brand.
Incremental revenue streams.
Yeah.
So now you see I have agency. I have MC, Mziki. And now I want to get into radio. So those are how many revenue streams,
bro? I get it.
Pali pali bado matepe zangu zinauzauza. Sonde sonde. Bali pali MCSK bado inandrushia ka 7-8 na ya kutoa.
2300.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
Nashukuru. So, and I've no training in media. In fact, my degree is in marketing. IBA, biashara. But ile confidence buda. Jusu ni kuongea na watu. Sumina kuongea na watu sai. Buda nishikani. So anyway, Jalangu akaniambia ina shida. Akuorganizia. So Jalas calls me, is like, budo ko free siku, come on Mdosi. So Caroline Mtoko was the programs controller of KIS 100. So me had done my research. KIS nasikia wanafungwa ma station mpya, sijui kuna Smooth, sijui kuna X, kuna Radio Jambo, sijui nini. Hizo hazikuwa zimeanza. So I had done my due diligence, company research. So nikiingia pale, najua hii media house inenda wapi. I had this pink shirt, bro. My best shirt. I had one amazing shirt. Apart from that shirt, I had like t-shirts is a Coke, yeah. Is a brand then product.
Sao.
Yani nilikuwa na hii t-shirt ya pink, muda nikapiga pasi. Pasi ingine sijaiona. Nikaemtokea. Na kiatu ingine loafers, they are white. Mimi na kastalit kango, Leon's place.
Mm.
Nikaingia, nikaongelesha Caroline Toko, she asked me questions. She asked me why radio. I told her, man, me, I just want to talk to people, man. I'm good, I'm talented. Do you have any training? No. Any experience? No. But ile confidence nimeingia nayo.
Mm.
Okay. Could you like to do a voice test? Because you need to have a, I told her I'm ready to do the voice test now.
Mm.
Siachili nafasi. I told her I have had you strength administration, need new presenters, I'm ready, I'm cool, I'm fresh, I'm vibrant, nimeji package. Hata sijabeba CV. Sina ene. Naelewa. Ile tu nimeingia tu pale na shati ya pink, kiatu ya white na
na confidence. Na confidence.
Na style. Sale tu pia inaniaibisha na kwa makwama nini? Unajua Toyota zinakuwa na kitu inaitwa miss. Wow. Grogon. Tutarudi hapo. So nimeenda huko juu.
Wait, hold on, let's change some batteries. Tutarudi.